chest pokud tu tak prista krenko. Jak ovka.
Yes, I bet you have.
Hey guys, it's Steph. Welcome back to the Cantina. Today I want to talk a little bit about some things you might have been hearing from bigger channels like Doomcock, Midnight's Edge, which is a really great channel, and Rose Rants, about what's been going on behind the scenes at Lucasfilm. Here's the deal. They're right. There's a lot more, and I'm going to try to fill in as much as I can without outing people. So, Doomcock reported that Kathleen Kennedy was thrown off the set of The Mandalorian by Favreau and Filoni. Now, there are lots of know-it-all, mostly men.
Heaven, she's bad, look at them.
It did. Midnight's Edge talked a little bit about that, other rumors, Lucas being back tentatively. Rhodes Rants talked about the same sort of things from a different perspective. These rumors are coming out not only from Context, but from Reddit and other places where things are leaked. I am going to add a little detail to this. I was talking to a friend, not going to say who it was, and he's got contacts with inside Disney with one of the top studio guys. Not gonna say who. And then I'll go into the shareholders meeting. And yes, there was yet another big meeting between the honchos at Lucasfilm. And Kennedy was there, Iger was there, Filoni, Favreau, were there. I assume Alan Horn was there and probably some other people. J.J. Abrams was there too. I think that's weird to me. In my opinion, that's weird. While this was going on, Iger introduced another person that showed up. That person was George Lucas. Lucas came in. They started discussing what was going to happen. Kennedy made her pitch. Lucas shot her down. They all shot her down. Lucas basically said, I want full control of everything anymore. They talked about retconning the ST, rewriting it. They talked about other projects. He was very angry at The Mandalorian. Kathleen Kennedy lied about how many scripts were actually done. There were scripts that were done. From what I heard, Lucas thought they were too PC, too SJW, and he wouldn't have it. And they're in the process of fixing it. Now, we heard from Midnight's Edge that people at Pinewood Studios got texts and emails basically saying, when you come back for Kenobi, you will be dealing with somebody different, as in not Kathleen Kennedy. This has been long in the making, all right? Now, I want to go to the shareholders meeting because I'm going to tie all this together. All right. So, Craig at Reviews for You is at the shareholders meeting, and well, he listened to it. You get to call in, and he's got voting shares of the Wazoo. So, he was sitting there listening to it, and Lehman Brothers asked about Star Wars. Other important investors, I would say Goldman Sachs and some other heavy hitters, asked about George Lucas coming back. Was Kennedy going to be leaving soon? Yada, yada, yada. Bob Iger avoided all of it. Okay. I'm going to tie this up now. There's a reason why none of this has ever been confirmed officially. Why this is all rumor and conjecture. Why, you know, know-it-all guys, and I'm not going to name them, tell the rest of us who are like, this is really going on. Because everybody in Hollywood's talking about it. tell you that you're wrong. It hasn't been official, because if it comes out that Kathleen Kennedy is gone, that Lucasfilm is in a state of complete disarray, if it comes out that they did not make a goddamn dime on The Rise of Skywalker, okay, you can't spend $375 million making and producing a movie, $300 million on marketing, and then at the end, after all the costs are taken out, when you only net about $200 million, you lost a lot of money, okay? You do not, you don't balance your checkbook like that. You don't look at your finances and think, wow, I put $20 in thinking I was going to get 80 back, and I got 4. See? Okay. That's why Iger and everybody, all the suits, all the finance guys at Disney are terrified. The stock at Disney is artificially high. It's 300, what, companies? And they're all not doing great. Okay. They're under an SEC investigation for messing around with the Captain Marvel box office, so it looked like it made $1 billion. But I seem to remember all kinds of anecdotal evidence saying to the contrary. All right. What's the other clue that says something is going on? We're getting the Blu-ray the same exact date, same exact time period. It's got the Blu-ray digital of The Last Jedi. But, and this is a big, giant but, and it is the elephant in the room, no deleted scenes, no director's commentary. I can leave you guys with this, and then you can all just kind of go and do what you want. Paolo Hidalgo, his Twitter account is hidden, so no one can actually read it, posted on Twitter that if Reylos knew what the beginning had actually been, they would be really mad. Okay. And I think I know what it was. Rey and Kylo Ren, brother and sister. And that was what was wanted. That was what the fans wanted. Something like that. Something like that. JJ didn't get to have Matt Smith in it. Harrison Ford, all the other work he did for this movie was gone. Why? So Bob Iger and Alan Horn and Alan Horn's social media spreadsheet could be happy. And guess what? Because Mule Face died, the rat faced boy died, the Reylos are furious. You ruined an entire franchise for a very loud, small minority of incel teenage girls and fat, sexless, virginal cat lady, middle-aged cat ladies. Well done, Disney. Well done. But are the Reddit leaks true? Did JJ basically say last summer when they were redoing everything, you might as well say this movie was directed and written by Disney Lucasfilm? There's the evidence. No deleted scenes. And no director's commentary. This is Steph, signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy. Oh, and I'm thinking about doing another channel. And it's going to be about the culture at large, other things beyond Star Wars, maybe movies, politics, just for a difference. With the presidential election coming up, I really kind of would like to not necessarily throw my two cents in, because I don't really like talking about politics to people that I don't really know, but there's a lot of stuff going on. It's very interesting to me, and I would like to throw my two cents in. So get ready. I don't know what I'm going to call it, but I'm thinking about it.